got heavy clay soil. Don't worry, we'll fix it. Let's get into it. Thanks for watching the video today. I'm Diego, D-I-E-G-O, and my goal is to help you streamline gardening, to make gardening easier using smart design. A lot of us gardeners are stuck, or so we think, with heavy clay soils, meaning soils that are dominated by clay, which ends up forming large chunks known as clods, making gardening difficult and making it hard for plants to grow. To fix that, we need to loosen up the soil by changing the soil texture and soil structure. Soil texture versus soil structure. You may think they're the same, but they're actually different. I did a whole video on this, which I'll link to below, but here's the quick dirty on them. Soil texture is the physical makeup of your soil. It's what's in your soil. It's a mixture of sand, silt, and clay. Soil structure is how that mixture comes together in the ground and how it forms aggregates known as clods. It could be loose, granular, or blocky. Think of a heavy clay soil or a tight soil structure like a locked door. When the root hits that locked door, what happens? Can't get through there, but we open the door and, whoa, that's easy. Open door, loose soil structure, roots go in. Tight soil structure, locked door in, roots can't get in. What inspired me to take on this topic and do this series of videos was the clay in some of my newer garden beds. A lot of my newer garden beds have clay chunks just like this. They're throughout the garden bed and they run anywhere from golf ball size to softball size. And it's a pain to dig through, and I've noticed poor performance in those areas where the clay chunks are really big. The plants just don't grow as well. So what I'm after is a nice loose granular soil like this potting mix here, and I need to get rid of these big clay chunks. So how can we change our soil structure and soil texture? I came up with 5 different ways to do that on a garden scale. And I rank these in terms of the work that goes in and the amount of inputs that need to go in for that particular process, 1 being the least, 5 being the most. Let's take a look at that list. Use plants, amend the soil, broad fork it, double dig it, and build it up. Those range from 1 on the easy scale and 1 on the input scale to 5 on the work scale and 5 on the input scale. Each of these 5 techniques will change both the soil texture and soil structure. 1, use plants. The great thing about plants is they come with roots, and the great thing about roots is they can reach areas of the soil that we can't get to easily. Roots break up the soil, wedging their way in to create pore spaces, leaving organic matter behind and openings for soil biology. Roots put out substances to feed microbes, which help aggregate minerals and bond particles together, which is great in loose soils. The great thing about plants is it does work. I remember one time visiting a grass-fed beef operation in Indiana and taking a look at the soil on that grass-fed beef operation versus the row crop right next door. The row crop was plowing all the time, annual crops, a lot of fertilizers. It was a heavy clay soil. It was very, very hard to dig through. On the other side of the fence, there was a grass-fed beef operation, rotational grazing, 100% continuous pasture that had been that way for like half a decade. It was much, much easier to dig through. There was no difference in the soil. The only difference was management. And that management involved allowing plants to loosen up the soil and change the soil structure. So if you want to change your soil structure, one easy way to do it is using plants. The great thing about plants is they work, but they're going to take a long time. This isn't an immediate solution, but it's a permanent solution as long as plants are growing. As long as you keep plants there, your soil structure will get better and better over time, and it will regress if you take the plants away. If you want to use plants to change your soil structure, how does that look in terms of workload and inputs? On the workload side, I'll say it's a 1 to 3, meaning on the front end, it's a 1. It's easy to seed the plants, but it's a little more work to manage them once they're growing, whether that's some sort of chop and drop or mowing. And in terms of the inputs required, it's a one. Seeds cheap, seeds easy. You don't need a whole bunch of soil or anything here. So it's a one on the input side of things, as good as it's gonna get. The number two strategy to change your soil texture and soil structure is to amend your soil. To amend our soil, we're gonna be adding minerals to it to move it in the direction we wanna go. So if we have a heavy clay soil, we add sand and we essentially dilute out the clay. When we introduce the sand into the clay soil, some of those sand particles get in between the clay chunks and they start breaking up the clay, making it hard for the clay to form larger clods, which changes the soil structure. You can also add organic matter to do this as an amendment, but don't forget that organic matter can be consumed. Sand can't be. Sand is forever. So I recommend if you have a big clay issue, use sand and follow it up with organic matter. While plants were a permanent solution as long as they were growing, sand is a truly permanent solution. So once it's in the soil, it will change your soil texture and soil structure forever. For amending, I'm gonna score this a 4 in terms of workload, because if you're gonna turn sand into your beds by hand, it's actually a lot of work. It's really hard work. And if you have really heavy soils, it's going to be hard work. Now, I know I said mechanical tillage wasn't one of my strategies, but this is one area where I would say a one-time mechanical till might be worthwhile if you have a lot of garden property, if you're not in the best shape and you just want to get this done quickly. Put a whole bunch of sand on your beds, till it up to mix it in, and then never till again. Tillage is a tool to introduce this change, and then you remove that tool from the toolkit. You can do it by hand, and that's what I did, and that's what you'll see me do in one of the upcoming videos, but damn, like, it's a lot of work. In terms of inputs, I'll say it's a 1 to 3, because depending on how bad your soil is, that's going to determine how much input you need to change it. If you have really heavy clay soils, you might need to bring in a lot of sand, which is very input intense. If you just have some clay and you want to try and move it closer to loam, you might just need a little bit of sand, hence less inputs. So overall, workload 4, inputs 1 to 3. The next way to change your soil structure is by using a tool called a broad fork. This is what I would call a combination technique, meaning I wouldn't just do broad forking on its own to change my soil structure. I would use it in combination with amending and growing plants. When you start stacking all these different techniques together, you get much better results. The tines on a broad fork break up soil clods, which allow roots to penetrate into the soil. Breaking up the clods also allows you to get sand and organic matter in between the particles. I think this is a tool to help solve the problem, not a solution in and of itself, meaning if you had a very heavy clay soil and you just broad forked it to kingdom come, I don't think that's going to change your soil structure. I think you're gonna need to combine it with amending and plants in order to see results. This will definitely change your soil structure by breaking up some of the chunks, but you won't see a change in the soil texture unless you amend alongside it. Broad forking in terms of work, I'll say it's a 3. It's hard, but it's not the hardest thing on this list. In terms of inputs, I'll say it's a 0 to 1. If you're just broad forking in between crop rotations, you're probably not adding anything to the bed. You're just broad forking by itself. No amendment required. If you're doing this on a new bed, you're gonna need some inputs, and you're not gonna like put 5 inches of sand on top of your bed and then try and broad fork it. You're probably just gonna sprinkle some sand on top of your bed and then broad fork it, because when you do the broad forking action, that sand penetrates through the cracks, so you don't want too much on top anyway. The fourth way to change your soil structure is by double digging. Now you may ask, what the heck is double digging? Here's an illustration of it on screen right here. This is a process of removing the upper layer of soil and then loosening the subsoil below the layer that you removed. I will do a video on double digging in the future, so I'm not going to go too much into detail now. When you double dig, you can amend with sand and or organic matter in the process. This will definitely change your soil structure and soil texture if you amend. In terms of work, double digging is probably the hardest thing you'll ever do in your garden. I mean that literally. Unless you're digging out a huge stump of a tree, You're not going to find anything much harder than double digging. It's a lot of work and it takes a lot of time. It's for sure a 5 on the workload scale. In terms of inputs, it's a 1 to 2. You're definitely going to want to amend when you do this, or at least I think you're going to want to amend. If you're going through all the work of double digging, you have all your soil pulled up, you better get some organic matter and some sand down in there while you're doing it and not waste that work opportunity. So it is a lot of work, but like a lot of things that require hard work, it works at the end of the day. The fifth way to change your soil structure, or kind of cheat and work around it, is to just build up. Bad soil, no problem. Let's just build up and make our new soil. Something you could do anywhere with any soil, even on concrete. It's an easy and fast solution. It has other benefits as well, like you can do a 100% custom soil blend. You can change the drainage of your soil by lifting the soil up. You can raise the working height of your soil. Now, this doesn't solve the subsoil problem, so I would try to break up that subsoil if possible before building the raised bed. Otherwise, the roots are gonna go down through the raised bed, which is all nice, great soil, and then they're gonna hit the ground below that was so hard, and they're not gonna be able to go anywhere, and they're probably just gonna go sideways. But obviously, if you're going the raised bed route because your ground was so hard, this might be a challenge to begin with. Nonetheless, if you're building a raised bed, try and loosen up the soil below that bed before you raise it. In terms of workload for building up, I'd say it's a 2. I don't think it's that hard. You just pour a bunch of stuff down on the ground, you rake it up, it's pretty easy. But in terms of inputs, it's a true 5 because you're starting with nothing and you got to build a whole bed on top of it. That's going to require a massive amount of soil and or organic matter. So input heavy, workload not so much. But if you're dealing with really hard soils or an area that just has rock or something else below it, the only way to go is up. There you have it, 5 different ways to change your soil texture and soil structure. Coming up, I'll go through all 5 of these techniques in the field so you can see them in action and figure out which one might work best in your garden. Remember, if you have very heavy soil, or loose soil for that matter, you're not stuck with it. You can change it, and hopefully this series will help you get that change started. Thanks for watching. Until next time, be nice, be thankful, and do the work.